Jim moved to Calgary in 1993, got married here in 1997, the year we talk about. And Jim is the ultimate connector. Those of you that know Jim know, he knows everybody. And if you ever say, he says, I know a guy, I know a gal, I know somebody, I can help you with that. Village Brewery is his latest endeavor. He's one of the co-founders of Village Brewery, and he uses that to build community. And there are singers and songwriters and artists and painters and other cultural people in our city who owe a huge debt of gratitude to Jim for getting their career started, because that's what he believes in doing. So I thought, instead of just picking on him, I would force him to come up here and do his show and tell. Could you please welcome Jim Button to the stage? Do you want me to do the reveal?
I'm not quite sure what's going to happen yet.
You know, me neither.
So as you guys have seen, anybody that's been to the show before knows that Dave's favorite thing is to pick on me. I'll tell you the story about where that came from. When we started talking about this show for Dave, I always thought Dave's really great. When stuff goes sideways, Dave is awesome at picking it up and making it funny and engaging, and he just flows with it. And I've always thought, you know what would be really great is if we actually threw a surprise at Dave on each show. And he said, that sounds like a great idea. So the surprise has always been on me, which is the unfortunate part. So he actually turned it back on me. Last time I was wearing an elf costume, which was really awkward. And I had to organize the game, which is really terrible. And I apologize for anybody that had to watch that. So I'm about to apologize for what is about to happen as well. Because I did have 10 minutes. Well, 10 minutes plus the time I've been sitting there scrambling, trying to think of what I'm going to do. So as for my show and tell, I didn't have much on me. So it's what I had on me. I had my phone. Well, I had the clothes that I was wearing, but I didn't think putting those on the table would be a good idea. I had my phone, my wallet, my briefcase, and my wedding ring. This one is my phone. We all have one of these, and they're spectacular. They're also a pain in the butt. You have to figure out how to manage them, and we're dealing that with our 16 and our 14-year-old right now. But what's beautiful about this, as Dave said, I consider myself a connector. This is critical to me to connect people. I am doing it every day, all day. It also happens to be the conduit to my one of my two daytime jobs that support me. It's with a digital marketing company called Evans Hunt. This is my wallet. You probably, half of you have a wallet, the other half of you have something else that fits in a big bag of missing things. This is my wallet. This is a very interesting wallet. It was made by a gentleman named Jeffrey Cockham, also known as Johnny Tremendous. He's one of the artists that we support at the brewery, and he donated that wallet to me to say thanks for the help that we've done for him. I keep this one, and it's very important to me because it reminds me of all the great artists and people that make this city an awesome place. This is my briefcase. It is super cool, simply because it's made with bicycle tires and a seatbelt. And I tell you this story simply because I had the moment to help some friends that were starting a bike culture company. I spend a lot of hours for free helping them build this. The company didn't succeed, but I got a briefcase. Actually, what's neat in this briefcase, I wasn't planning on showing this, but I'm kind of panicking, so I'll just show you this now. This is a computer, because it's the fifth thing on this table. This is really interesting. This is a picture of me. For those of you that don't know, I had cancer last year, a year and a half ago. And what was really neat about this picture is the people at Evans Hunt said, when I was away on my little kidney vacation, they said, Jim does an awful lot for our community. Let's do something for him. So they made, I think, 1,500 of those stickers. And when I came back, they stuck them around all over the city, which was pretty cool. I have 5 minutes, right? So all right. This is the most important one. This is the one ring that rules them all. Actually, it's the second. It's Match is the one ring that rules them all. This is the one ring that listens to the ring that rules them all. My wife's in the audience. So this is very important to me. This, I'll tell you about the ring first. It was made by a gentleman by the name of Norbert Brinkhaus, a family friend of my wife. And it's a hammered 24-karat gold ring, and it is very soft. It's very heavy. Hear how heavy that was? It's very heavy, and it's very malleable. And it has been, it's not round anymore. It's been crushed, it's been scratched, it's been dented, it's been rounded, it's been smoothed, and it's pretty emblematic of my life. And I've got nothing but good has come from this ring. Wow. And when I was when I moved here in 1993, the very first person I met was my wife. And nothing but good has happened since that day. I owe everything to my wife, and I wanted to say thank you very much, and I appreciate it. That's my show and tell.
That was so good.
Yeah. If things don't go well for you tonight, Jim,
yeah,
you got the song and you got that, then that's all you need.